Sandeep, when we are talking about experiences, deep experience, each experience is limiting itself. So how one experience can lead to a deeper experience? Because whatever experience what we have from the past.
See, every experience is undoubtedly limited. But is even the basis, the source of experience limited? Take a small thing. You watch something in a shop. You come across something displayed in a shop. And it arouses a certain reaction from you. The reaction is obviously a limited thing. You can keep walking and go past that object. It's just a small thing, right? You know, you let's say you look at a mannequin and you're reminded of some moment. And you have something, a bottle of soft drink in your hand and sipping it comfortably, you can go away. But is that momentary reaction just momentary? Or is it a product of your total conditioning? Being reminded of that woman, is that a story of a moment or is that a story of a lifetime? If you can go deeply into it, won't you see the entire architecture of the mind laid bare in front of you? Won't you? Does that one fleeting experience not have the key to everything that is there?
Yes.
Please answer this.
Yes.
And in knowing that experience, have you not come upon that which knows? We just said that witnessing is nothing apart from the deepest experiencing. If you can fully know that experience, what is going on? What do we do usually with these things? We throw them away or we relegate them to the dustbin of the mind.
Mm-hmm.
Just as the mind is everything, the mind also has a small dustbin. What we don't like, we throw into that dustbin. So we throw these things away. Now, instead of throwing it away, if I can pay a little attention to it, won't it just reveal everything? Won't it? So, you see, is there anything that the ocean has and the drop has not? Tell me. And if you are synonymous to a drop, would you ever have the wherewithal to study the ocean?
No.
What
no.
can you study? Would you study
yes.
the entire ocean or the drop?
The drop.
Remember, you are no bigger than a drop. Would the drop go to study the ocean? Or would the drop rather study itself, the drop?
Itself.
And the drop is so small and limited. But in studying the drop has known everything that the ocean is. Are you getting it?
Yes.
So that is what I meant by saying that every single smallest experience has the key. You don't have to search for anything beyond yourself. Now I just, you know, picked this up and the tea in this cup has gone cold. And then there was a certain response here. If I can know what it means to not have your expectations met, then I have known what it means to live. Because life never conforms to your expectations. I kept speaking and I picked this up and this comes to my lips and it is cold. And my expectations have been belied. If I can just see how I am in this moment when the cup meets the lip, I've known life. I've known life. Are you getting it?
Yes.
So, that's why wise men, the saints, all the people here that we hold in great respect, that's why they have again and again said that it is there. Moko kahan dhoole re bande, where are you searching for me? Main saasan ki saas mein. Remember Kabir?
Yes.
I am in the breath of your breath, so close. Now where are you looking for me? That's what. It's there, here.
Sir, as you said, just to be more on the clear side, that right now you said that pay attention to the moment, study it. So these words seems like an act of thought.
Yes. No, it is. It's just a matter of language, and I appreciate what you're saying. The moment you say study, it looks like an elaborate activity. An elaborate activity that would take time. When I'm saying pay attention to it or study it, what I mean is something that is very instantaneous. You know it just like this. You know it just like this. The cup meets the lip and you know it just like this. What is this knowing? Please understand. There is the experience. Knowing that experience is what I'm calling as studying. That's just that much. Nothing more than that. It's so simple.
So that actually cannot come from us trying deliberately to know.
No, it cannot come from you trying deliberately. It can only come when you are not preoccupied with this and that. It can only come when you are available. When you are available to let the experience speak to you.
So, I am not sure, but is the key basically lies in honesty, because when you are honest...
Yes, it lies in honesty. I like to say that it lies in fearlessness. Because you see, these are the same things. Honesty and fearlessness are not two different things at all. But if I have to pick one word,
yes,
then that word would be fearlessness. Because the way this world is, it is fear that keeps us down.
Okay. Shy away from acknowledging.
Yes, you shy away from acknowledging, whatever. And if you are thinking of other things, if you are not available to acknowledge this experience, even the other things that you are thinking of are there in your life only due to fear. Pay attention to all that you keep thinking of. All those thoughts would have the color of fear. The various colors of fear. Fear comes in many different shades and forms. You're thinking of something pleasant, is there not fear in it? You're thinking of something unpleasant, is there not fear in it? And if it is neither pleasant nor unpleasant, would you ever think of it? So thoughts are always colored in fear. You have to be free from that preoccupation so that this experience, this happening, this so that this, you know, talks to you and you are able to receive what it is saying. It's always telling you something, it's always teaching you.